first principals in Australia, I think. You are absolutely stunning. Inside and out. Without a doubt, you are a true testament to what the future holds, and I'm very, very proud of you. You have made it through the HSC. Yes. And now, everything begins again. You're done with us. You won't be listening to me on assembly anymore. Now you go, oh. That's good, thank you. That makes me feel just a little bit better. Uchi. There won't be many more of these advice talks that I give you. Again, you go, oh. The staff are doing it. That's a bit sad, isn't it? We will truly miss you. And this is the last time we're actually going to be in the one room together, unless there's a wedding coming up or some sort of birthday celebration. So this will be the last time. I'm wondering what you're going to be like in 10 years' time. Can you imagine? Would you still be sitting next to the same people? Will you be sitting next to your husband or wife? With your 10 children? No, 11 children, okay, got it. Who will you be? What will you be doing? Be president? You think Australia's going to have a president? And it's going to be you? We could try. Raise your hand if you'd vote for him. His table didn't even vote for him. Okay, so we might not have a president in the room. I had the privilege of going to a 10-year anniversary of the class of 2005. At the weekend, and one of the class of 2005 is actually in this room. Can you guess who it is? No, it's not me. Thanks for the flattery. That's something you can find out during the evening. And it was really nice talking to people about what they'd done in 10 years. And there was a civil engineer, there was some teachers, a pharmacist. There was somebody that just bought a small business driving buses. But what was more important was not what they were. It was actually who they were. And so my encouragement to you is whatever you do, whatever you're going to pursue, whatever your path is, please make sure that you're a person worthy of being a Cabramatta High School student, a person who is somebody that cares about the universe, the planet, and the people in it. Because that's what will make you a truly wonderful person. It's not what you do, it's who you are. And I know that you're going to make a difference in the world because you already have made a difference in my life. So thank you for being part of the journey at our school. Thank you for enriching my life and the life of those around you. And have the best night. Thank you.
It's really good to see you all dressed up. Whoever knew you would grow up so well, eh?
Oh,
so, well done on that. I think following on from Miss Godwin, tonight really is a celebration. It's a celebration on finishing the HSC. It's a celebration of moving on to the next sort of stage of your life, of the new adventures and where you're going to. And you've had a few weeks after the HSC now, so you're starting to go on that journey already. can start to feel that. So during the night, make sure you do take lots of photos. You are the generation of selfies. You are the generation that invented the selfie stick. So make plenty of selfies tonight. I suppose the thing with Capra, yes, okay, I get on your back sometimes. But I was talking to a student today, and she'd come from a different school. And she'd been with us for a few weeks. And I said, oh, what do you think? She said, oh, it's so hard here. Back at the other school, it was all easy. Didn't have to do very much. And here, you know, we've got to do all this stuff and have to do all this work. And I think what we all try and do is we try and set the bar high for you so you can jump as high and higher than you ever thought you can. And that's what we try and do. So the skills which you've learned, all the different qualities at the school, take those on in your life. Canberra students go out and they succeed. They do amazing things. And those amazing things are right ahead of you. So go and reach, take what you've learned at the school, and go ahead, great, have a great life, and have a great celebration tonight because you deserve it.
Thank you, Mr. Erskine, for those inspiring words. Next up, we are going to have the two pillars of our HSC life, the two strengths who we can always fall back on. So I'd like to call up on Mr. Tran and Mr. Keogh to step forward and take the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I can refer to you guys as ladies, young ladies and gentlemen today. We are very proud of you and of how far you've come. A couple of weeks ago at the graduation ceremony, you would remember that I began my speech with a proverb that it takes a village to raise a child. And I'm very proud, all the teachers in this room are very proud that we have helped you on your way, and I still believe that today it takes a community to raise the young men and women that are here today with us, or tonight with us. So let's all tonight celebrate to you so you can give yourself a big round of applause. Now, before I say anything else, I'd like to thank particularly the staff members who have contributed all their efforts and all their work towards tonight, and also the graduation ceremony that was very successful. So I'd like to thank the following staff members, particularly Mr. Erskine and Mr. Kadia, who worked tirelessly behind the background. Ms. Walton and Mr. Avery, who are here as well, Ms. McKillie, Ms. Marisin, Ms. Knight. Ms. Canty, Mrs. McGilligot, who is not here, and Mr. Abbott as well. Please give them all a big round of applause. I'd like to also thank the Languages Department for organising the gowns as well, so that made you look so wonderful that day as well. Now, there are four staff members, you know, who have been instrumental in your development as well as mine. And I'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge them. And I'll tell you, you don't mess with these four people here, okay? So I call them the Big Four. All right, so I'd like to thank, firstly, Mrs. Gooden, who's not here with us. Mr. Erskine, who's also helped you along the way as well. Mr. McKeown as well, who is not here. And finally, your principal, Miss Godwin. Please give me a big round of applause. Now, to the class of 2015, I'd like to wish you the best of luck in all your endeavours. Whatever field that you choose to pursue and to enter, I'd ask that you do that with integrity. Have a good night and a safe night. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I'm a man of few words. Thank you. Thanks. First of all, adding to Sir's thank yous, thank you to everyone he's mentioned again. But most importantly, I think tonight, the whole pretty much senior year have been made easier by an amazing group of people that Sir and I have had the pleasure of working with. They've given up their lunch times to organise events for you, organise fundraisings for you, to make tonight cheaper for you as well. The leadership group, everyone that's worked up in the library selling and fundraising and giving up their afternoons and their precious time that they could have been using to study. Okay, and they've done it for you guys. So I think they deserve a big round of applause. Also, there are a few other people, people that worked on videos, Anna, Cindy, Sandy, people that worked on the invitations. Some of you got the student invitations. Teachers, we got these amazing invitations, probably the best invitations I've ever seen. They're the only ones I've seen as well. Thank you, Cindy. Also, another person that's been working really, really hard behind the scenes. She's, along with working so hard doing this, she's also excelled in every other field you can think of, you know, art and academia and sport. You know who she is, Ellie. Well done. Otherwise, that's and everyone else who's made this really fun. I've really enjoyed teaming up with Sir and adopting you guys as my nephews and nieces and my kids. But I've got a few words I just want to leave you with, okay? And I'd like to thank Vitamin C. As we go on, we remember all the times we've had together. As your lives change from whatever, we will still be friends forever. Thank you.
I'm sorry. And I wish you guys all good luck. I, people who I've known, you guys have helped me and others learn through different experiences. And I hope you guys continue to learn new and different experiences because they can actually help you in life.
Everyone just covered basically everything I wanted to say, but again, I just like to say that we have started this wonderful journey, and now we're nearly at the end. And it actually feels great, you know, like because we finished it, you know, we didn't just drop out or we didn't just do what other people did. We stuck through it, you know. No matter through like all the tantrums and all the everything, we stuck through it and we are getting an A star, you know? I would just like to say that I wish you guys all the best of luck for whatever you guys do, and I hope to see you in university or, like Tim said, in TAFE, or probably working in McDonald's or barbecue, I don't know, anytime. I'll see you then. Thank you.
Thank you guys. We'd also like to give a thank you to all the teachers and staff who have been through our high school life with us. And thank you for making this nice, this night something to remember. And thank you to everyone who came today. And don't forget to make a lot of memories because we won't have this night again. Thank you to Mr. Tran and Mr. Kerr, especially, who've always been through us to this crazy high school adventure and stuck through it with us. And yeah, don't forget to enjoy your night, guys.
Okay, Cameron Matter, I think you should do a massive round of applause for your teachers and
we'll be right back. Oh, over there the other corner.
Oh, good, good. That's filming.
That's filming. You're on 3D.
We'll be right back.
She said, oh, should be a little bit louder than that. Thank you so much, guys.
One more song.
We love you guys so much.
Yeah! Picture that with a Kodak. I better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Turn my life from negative to positive. I just want you to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life. Pitbull, Nadia, Neo, that's
I'm gonna take you home with me if I could.